acha wafike Mukam Mukam
Mukam Mukam decide
and kina Farhada because we are trying to show that in lieu of unity.
You guys open up a bit. Open up, you guys.
Come here, Moshi.
Yeah, Falhada.
Falhada.
Falhada. And your food in the Aisha.
As much as you are to meet it, are you ready? Nafikiri tungeanza kwa kusema, tungeanza na kusema mimi ni kwa mjumbe wa hapa wa kaunti hii, na shukuru wajumbe wote ambao wamekuja. Tuna wajumbe zaidi ya 25 ambao tuko nao hapa, na ningetaka watu wakuwe mfano ya Kenya kuona wajumbe ambao tunaye nidhamu ile wanaye ya juu, kwa sababu tunasikiza kesi, tunangoja process iende vile inaenda, na tunaheshimu process, na hiyo ndio tukitaka hata raia wale wako nje waweze kusoma na process kama hii, kwa sababu tunajua kama ni wale wengine fujo ingekuwa mingi, demonstration ingekuwa mingi, na mambo mingi ya uhalifu mali ya watu. Lakini sisi tunasema we want to be okay with the process. Imewekwa siku saba, tunagoja na koti tunaiheshimu, tungoje tuone process. Lakini mnajua kuna ile kifungo isiyo ya kawaida, hiyo tunajua kifungo ambaye sio ya kawaida, na kuhakikisha sisi kama wajumbe mtu unawekwa siku 10 14 15 bila kufuata sheria ambayo iko, lakini tunaheshimu process hiyo iendelee namna hiyo. One day Mungu atatusaidia sheria iweze kuheshimiwa. Na ninashukuru sana jaji wa jana ambaye alikuwa amepelekewa governor, alisikiza na akapeana bail hapo hapo. Hii ni kusema wana mamlaka na inaonekana yes independent. Hatusemi yu si independent, lakini ningeomba tukae namna hiyo, tuheshimiane na raia waangalie sisi vile tunakaa, kwa sababu tunakuwa accused kwa mambo mengi, but we are the most humble MPs ambaye 25 MPs wakiwa pahali kama ni pahali nyingine ingekuwa chaos, but we are very calm. Na hata polisi jua namna hiyo, even next wakaba tunakuja hapa hakuna haja ya polisi, we have no problem, we always come. Lakini nayo wasivurovoku watu ianze kuwa na shida. Hiyo ndio ningesema. Nashukuru wajumbe wote ambao wamekuja hapa, wale wanasimamia sisi kama mawakili, tunawashukuru sana. Tuna wawakili hapa wa mama, wanaume, na leo wanasema sisi tunataka heshima, kwa sababu hata serikali ijayo tunataka ikuwe heshima na kuheshimu judiciary.
Asante, thank you very much. Kama Senator Wanakuru, I'm also here to first of all thank you very much for all of you members of parliament who have come and stood with the people of Nakuru County and Honorable Sudi as well. And obviously we are not it's also quite a sad day that he has to remain in custody for another 7 days. It seems a bit unusual, but again we are here, we are respecting the process, we are following the process, but at the same time we would wish that justice is meted out without being unfair to some and maybe a bit more favorable to others. But I'm just putting that out there like that. But to the Kenyans who are watching us, to the Kenyans who are listening to us, I want you to see how much of a united people we are. We are one Kenya actually. And when I look here, I see my colleagues from Wajir, I see my colleagues from Garissa, from Kilifi, from Kuria, from Mombasa, from Nyeri, from Kirinyaga, from every part of this county, Uasin Gishu, Nakuru, everywhere. So for you Kenyans who are watching us, even in times like this, I would wish to urge that we remain united and we do not let anybody come between us in anything and in any way. So we say we shall continue following the process and we shall await to hear what happens in the next few days. Thank you.
Okay.
First, I would like to thank the members of the press for the time that they have been able to disseminate the information of what has been going on in the court to all the entire public. And again, I'd like to be able to explain to the public what has transpired today. If you remember, the prosecution had applied for an extension of 14 days custody for Honorable Sudi on the grounds that he would interfere with witnesses, two, that he would interfere with the discovery of who is the owner of a certain motor vehicle, that he would interfere with the ballistics investigations, and that he would cause more incitement. The magistrate's ruling has been good and has agreed with us that it is not possible for Honorable Sudi to interfere with NTSA, because that is something that can be sought in a few minutes from an application on the phone. I think that's what the magistrate has said. The magistrate has also said that it is not possible for Honorable Sudi to interfere with the ballistics investigations because he's not the director of the Firearm Licensing Bureau. The magistrate has also agreed in the ruling that it is not possible for Honorable Sudi to interfere with witnesses, because usually those witnesses should be named. Before you claim that they can be interfered with, they should be named. But the magistrate also went on to say that even though the witnesses are imagined and speculated and not named, they wanted to balance the...
So the place launches next week, Wednesday. What date is it? What is that? 23rd? Mention on 23rd to confirm whether the accused, I mean the responded by the child or this child, so that we can also close this miscellaneous file. So 23rd of September. So my Zoom at 2:30. So we got my orders. On behalf of Mr. Honor, thank you. Let me just read my final order. The order that the respondent be taken to keep waiting for treatment is hereby extended for such period as the respondent will fully recover, or the period for detention shall lapse, whoever comes first. And secondly, the defense shall be supplied with certified copies of proceedings and ruling by their cost. Court mentioned on 23rd September 2020 via Zoom at 2:30 p.m.
One more thing, Your Honor, with your permission, are you able to give us a morning time? Could we come to you in the morning? Because, Your Honor, we have advocates traveling from far. Then after the session, we'd have to travel back to Nairobi and Eldoret. Do you indulge us for morning hours?
Let me check with my clerk. What? I'm 9:30. 9:30. 9:30 in the morning, is that okay?
That is convenient, Your Honor. Thank you so much.
So 9:30 a.m.